we have to separate into partial fractions our fraction. So first, what it means? We need to express fraction, our fraction, as the sum of two or more fractions that are each simpler than the original. First, we have to always check the power of numerator and the denominator. In this example, in the numerator we have t to first power, the highest power is, and in the denominator when we multiply t times t will be t squared. So we have in the denominator power greater than the numerator. So everything is okay. If you have in the numerator power greater than denominator, you have to do first long division. But in this example, everything is okay. Next step, we have to check the denominator. The denominator we have to factorize. But in this example, we have this. Our denominator is factorized. So we have to check our factors. We have t minus 2 and t minus 4. There are different factors and they are linear factors. So next, each of these factors will be our denominator of partial fractions. Next, we will copy our example. We have 2 times 5t minus 17 over t minus 2 times t minus 4. Like I said, now every factor will be the denominator. So we will have t minus 2 and in the second denominator will be t minus 4. Next, because like I said, we have linear factor t minus 2, t minus 4. They are linear factors. So in the numerator, we have to always have the lower degree than the denominator. In the denominator, we have t to first power. So now in the numerators, we will have only constant. You can write a and b. Why? When we have in the denominator t to first power, so in the numerator will be t to zero power. T to zero power gives me 1. So we don't have t in the numerators. So now our unknowns are a and b. To find a and b, first we have to get rid of the denominators. How we do this? We will multiply each side of the equation by the lowest common denominator. So what will it will be? It always the denominator of our original fraction. So it will be t minus 2 times t minus 4. We have to multiply both sides by t minus 2 times t minus 4. Whole expression on the right side we have to multiply times t minus 2 times t minus 4. So now we see that the denominator of our left side will reduce t minus 2 with t minus 2 and t minus 4 with t minus 4. So we will have only 2 times 5t minus 17. This is equal. And now on the right side we have to multiply every fraction by this expression. So we will have a over t minus 2 times t minus 2 times t minus 4 plus b over t minus 4, we have to multiply, times t minus 2 t minus 4. So now we see that t minus 2 we can reduce and t minus 4 with t minus 4. So we will have, on the right side, we can do multiplication. We have to distribute 2 over each term in parentheses. So 2 times 5t is 10t, and 2 times negative 17 is negative 34. So this is equal. And on the right side, we have now a times t minus 4 plus b times t minus 2. Our unknowns are a and b. The easiest way when we have linear factors is to check what we can substitute t to reduce this whole term. When t will be 4, we will have 4 minus 4 give me 0. A times 0, so we will have 0. So, and for t equals 2, we will have t 2 minus 2 give me 0. So, b times 0 give me 0. For t equals 4 and for t equals 2, this terms will reduce. So first I will substitute t by 4. So now we have to substitute every t in our equation by 4. So we have 10 times 4 minus 34. This is equal a times 4 minus 4 plus b. And in parentheses, we'll have 4 minus 2. And now, 10 times 4 is 40 minus 34. This is equal a times 0 will be plus b times 4 minus 2 is 2. So 40 minus 34 is 6. This is equal a times 0. Give me 0. I don't have to write. So we have only b times 2. We need to find b. We have multiplication on the right side. So now I will divide both sides by 2 and 2 we can reduce. So we have on the left side 6 divided by 2 is 3. This is equal b. So I can rewrite this that b is equal 3. We found b. Now we have to find a. Like I said, for t equals 2, this term will reduce. So now, let me do this. For t equals 2, what will be? Now we have to substitute every t in our equation by 2. So we will have 10 times 2 minus 34. This is equal a, and in parentheses we will have 2 minus 4 plus b would be 2 minus 2 in parentheses. So 10 times 2 is 20 minus 34. This is equal a times 2 minus 4 is negative 2. And we have b times 2 minus 2 is 0. So we have 20 minus 34. How we do this? We have to keep the sign of the larger number. 34 is greater than 20, so negative sign we have to keep. And now we have to just subtract. 34 minus 20 is 14. This is equal. And we have on the right side only a times negative 2. Because we have multiplication, to get rid of negative 2, we have to divide both sides by negative 2. So negative 2 and negative 2 we can reduce. Negative 14 divided by negative 2. Negative and negative give me positive. And 14 divided by 2 is 7. So this is equal a. Let me rewrite this. A is equal 7. We found b and a. So now we have to come back to our example and we can rewrite our original fraction to sum of two partial fractions. So let me copy our original fraction. We have 2 times 5t minus 17 in parentheses over t minus 2 times t minus 4. This is equal a is 7, so we have 7 over t minus 2 plus b is 3 over t minus 4. So this is my solution. You can always check. If you add these two fractions, you will get exactly the same what we have on the left side.